Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Public dissatisfaction with this place has never been greater. It is true that when the country is so divided on Brexit, it was always going to be the toughest of challenges to earn public confidence and respect. However, the failure of leadership in both the major political parties, coupled with the rigid ideological dogma of some honourable members, has made the situation far worse than it needed to be. Party and dogma have sadly been put ahead of country. I've been consistent throughout. I believe the result of the referendum has to be respected. A belief in the central importance of democracy and the dire consequences for progressive politics, if we were to ignore or attempt to subvert the result, means we must leave. Holding a second referendum, irrespective of its result, would fuel a dangerous right-wing populism in our politics that is likely to lead to long-term right-wing governments in this country. However, Mr. Speaker, the basis on which we leave and engage with the European Union in the future is all important. It will shape our destiny for a generation. It must protect our economy, the standard of living of our constituents, and our security. We also have a solemn duty to preserve the United Kingdom, which should only ever change through explicit public consent, and protect the peace in Northern Ireland, which remains fragile. We should never forget that. Turning to the deal we are being asked to support tonight, it was overwhelmingly rejected back in January, largely because, not exclusively because, but largely because of the Northern Ireland backstop. The Brady Amendment passed by this House gave the Government a clear instruction that the backstop must be replaced in the withdrawal agreement by alternative arrangements. This hasn't happened, Mr. Speaker. Some proposed a time limit. This hasn't happened. Others wanted us to be able to unilaterally leave the backstop if negotiations fail. Again, this hasn't happened. So none of the conditions laid down by the vast majority of the original deal's opponents have been met, and this has been starkly underlined by the Attorney-General's legal advice of this morning. As I've said, I believe that we do have a duty to implement the referendum result and leave the EU, and I will only support a minimum extension to Article 50, which would ensure we are not obliged to participate in European elections. Therefore, I would be willing to consider supporting this agreement for all its imperfections, if only the Government was willing to be clear about their aspirations for our future relationship, for the sake of trade, jobs and living standards. This has to include a customs arrangement of some kind with the European Union. This could but need not be membership of the customs union itself. This is not only the best way of securing economic stability, it would also guarantee that the backstop is consigned to the dustbin of history. In my view, the best means of achieving this is Common Market 2, with the United Kingdom moving into the EFTA pillar of the European Economic Area and the UK joining a comprehensive customs arrangement with the EU, maintaining a common external tariff with frictionless trade and no hard border in Ireland. We would seek to maintain the closest possible economic relationship with the EU without the political integration which a majority in this country opposed very clearly in the referendum. The time has come to put this, along with other potential solutions, to the House so we can indicate where a majority can be secured. We know what the majority are against. The time has come for the majority in this place, free from the constraints of party whips, to make it clear what they are for. That would truly, Mr. Speaker, be acting in the national interest.